Check it out. Or hearing with your eyes.
Or smelling with my feet. Ah, now that is funky.
Let's make waves.
When Phoebe and Lester move their arms up and down, they send energy through the jump rope.
And look how that energy travels
in waves. All sound waves,
or any waves for that matter,
have three properties. Amplitude means how big the waves are, which determines how loud the sound is. Wavelength is how far it is from here to here. And frequency means the number of waves a sound produces in a second.
Low sounds have a low frequency.
And a long wavelength.
High sounds have a high frequency.
And a short wavelength.
So,
when I sing, that note has a lower frequency than when I sing,
Beak, my main man, I know you have got to suffer to play the blues, but watching this electrifying demo is more suffering than one rat man can take.
Oh, yeah, come on! Now let's answer the question already. How does a harmonica work?
Let's get the dope from the scope. Inside the holes of a harmonica are these little flat dealies called reeds. When you push or pull air over the reeds, they vibrate. The shorter ones vibrate faster, so they send out high-frequency waves, and we hear them as high notes. The longer reeds vibrate at slower frequencies, so they get down with the low notes. That's how you and your breath can make beautiful music together. And this frequency business isn't just for harmonicas, either.
When you pluck a guitar string, you get a note.
When you put your finger on the fret of your guitar, what you're really doing is shortening the string.
Which raises the frequency of the string's vibrations. The higher the frequency,
the higher the notes.
Talk to me, Lucy.
So, Zachary Mondell of Delano CA.
Thanks for your question. It really made our day.
A harmonica vibrates. That's such good news.
Its frequency is both high and low that help me play the blues.
We got the blues, those vibrating frequency blues. We got those knock me down,
tear me up,
vibrating frequency blues.
Oh.